Shanti, what exactly is ego, and how is it, what's it made out of?
Yes. The topic of ego is misunderstood. In pure sense, ego is I consciousness. Okay? When I consciousness and intellect meet together, it produces ego. When drishta and drushya work together, that means drishta means observer, I consciousness observer, and intellect is instrument. So when I consciousness uses intellect as instrument and identifies with the body, that means this together, consciousness and intellect, when identified with body, becomes body. When identified with senses, ego becomes senses. Identified with mind, it becomes a mind. So really, ego is pure consciousness contaminated because of wrong identification. So ego is produced by identification with body, senses and mind. So pure ego is to remove all the identification and we become pure ego or pure consciousness. And that is what is the purpose of meditation. To be pure consciousness and not identifying, I'm not the body, I'm not the senses, I'm not mind. That kind of affirmation, we become pure ego. So because of ego, we become trapped. There are two ways to be blissful. One way is like living like animals, where body, senses and mind, only these faculties work so that everything is surrender and natural. So nature will control when to eat, what to eat, when to sleep, when to wake up, and won't produce all the distractions or choosing, I like this, I don't dislike this, nothing of that. Then you'll be blissful. Other way to remain blissful is remain in the consciousness of I am. Then you remain blissful. So saints, holy people or evolved yogis remain at that consciousness. But most of the human beings have the problem. And problem is when consciousness gets trapped into the body and identifies oneself as a body, that is the trap, and that is where suffering comes. Body means our total faculty of body, senses and mind. So when consciousness identifies ourselves with the body, then we become body, and then we become limited. Actually, we are not limited, and we produce all the problems because of this identification. So really, that is the basic teaching of Patanjali. Drushta drushya ekatmata eva asmita. Asmita means ego. And because of ego, ignorance is produced. Because of ego, that wrong identity, attachment is produced. Attachment means likes and dislikes. Because of this ego, fear of death is produced. See, so ego is the cause of everything. So ego by itself is pure consciousness, but when it's trapped into the body, it becomes the body. And it becomes the body, then there's fear that I'm the body, I'm going to die. But when you realize I'm consciousness, I was never born and I will never die.